Hi guys, Matthew Woodward here, and today I'm going to show you precisely how I drive traffic to my blog. In January 2013, the blog received a total of 9,485 unique visitors, which actually ended up earning me a total of $9,511. All I did to get that traffic was find out where my audience lives online and then engage them directly with my personal help and content where possible. For the most part, I do this via forums, Q&A sites like Yahoo Answers, social networks, and other blogs in my niche. Reaching out and engaging my audience directly is the only thing I have done to drive traffic to the blog, and as you can see from the graph below, traffic has been steadily increasing. In just 5 months, the blog earned a total of $36,000 and has had two near $10,000 months in the last three. If you head over to the blog, you can see the full income report for yourself. Buzzbundle is a relatively new piece of software made by the team behind SEO Powersuite and is great for engaging your audience directly online. I've used the software for about 4 months now and was one of the first beta testers. I now use it as part of my daily promotional activities every morning, and it really does take the hard work out of finding and engaging your target audience online. And best of all, it's compatible with Windows, Mac and Linux. So what does it actually do? Well, first of all, it's capable of monitoring conversations on blogs, forums, Q&A sites and social networks. It will find relevant posts based on your keywords and then allow you to jump straight into the conversation within a single user interface. It will even handle any registration and email verification for you, so you can just focus on engaging your audience. You can also use it to track and manage all of your campaigns. So let's just get stuck in and I'll show you how I use it. So before we jump right into the nitty gritty of how to set it up and use it, I wanted to show you my personal project here. So we've got three columns, blogs and forums, Q&A sites and social networks. And you can see here there's a variety of highlighted terms, which are the keywords that I've got Buzzbundle set up to go and monitor and find posts for. So this is a Yahoo answer, for example, and this guy is asking, what is tiered link building in SEO? Well, I have got the perfect tutorial for you. Any of my regular readers will know about my tiered link building series, so I can answer this question. And I can just type in a message here saying something like, hi, I have created a dedicated tutorial series about tiered link building that you might enjoy. Please feel free to check it out via the link below. Feel free to ask me any questions if you get stuck. And I can then just paste my link into here. Oh, that's the wrong one. I can paste that link, the correct one, into there, hit OK, and that will now go out and submit the answer for me. And as we can see, status is done. We can see the question here. And if we actually jump into the browser here, you can see my answer is there. So that is really how powerful it is. That's just an example of a Yahoo answering a question. We've got all of these blog and forum posts that we can go through, and you know, just as easily, just click on reply, type your message in there, hit OK, and it goes and submits your message. So let's take a look at how to set up a Buzzbundle campaign from scratch. So I recently published a post comparing all of the popular backlink checkers, SEOmoz, Raven Tools, Ahrefs, Majestic SEO, and SEO Spyglass, and published a load of data comparing them all to see which was the best one. So let's take a look at how I'm going to use Buzzbundle to promote this post and drive traffic to it. So let's jump into Buzzbundle first of all. And the first thing we want to do is add our website, which in this case is my blog URL, matthewwoodward.co.uk, and hit next. Now, this is going to ask us for brand keywords, and this is a keyword that it actually goes out and searches for and returns the relevant conversations. So in this example, I want to return anything about Ahrefs, SEO Spyglass, Majestic SEO, SEO Moz, Open Site Explorer, and Raven Tools. So if we click on Next, and it asks us to select what specific networks we should monitor, I tick them all. You can see here there are a couple of grayed out that have not yet been introduced, but they're updating a software and adding more all the time, so I keep all of these ticked and click on Finish. And straight away this will go out and go and find a load of posts from forums and social networks that we can start interacting with straight away. So I'm just going to pause the video while it does that. So that has now returned quite a bit of data, and straight away we can see a post here by Anne Smarty on Search Engine Journal comparing Majestic SEO with Ahrefs. Funnily enough, that was published on the 5th of February, and she actually commented on my article on the 14th of January. So it would have been nice to get a mention in her follow-up post on Search Engine Journal, but that's just not how it crumbled this time. Anyway, let's jump back to Buzzbundle and let's take a look at some of the results here. So on top of this result here, already someone's mentioning my comparison in response to Anne. Thank you very much for that, Jacob, much appreciated. And there's lots of relevant comments here where we can just jump in and get involved. But before we do that, there's a few things that we need to set up. Now, the first thing I like to do is change these columns here, and I do that by clicking on the cog, clicking on edit, and here we can add and remove columns as we want. So I actually like to separate these out quite a bit, and you can see here the options that you've got. So I actually like this to be forums and blogs, and remove Q&A sites. That can stay as social networks, and this is going to become Q&A sites, mentions of my sites and keywords, and untick everything except Q&A sites. Okay, and I actually like the columns in this order. Okay, so you can see here the different columns. It's not actually fetched any questions yet. It will do that shortly. So if we jump into the options here, there's a couple of other things that we need to take a look at. So in here you can always add and remove any keywords for any posts that you want to promote, any content that you've got, or conversations that you want to monitor. You can also monitor your competitors as well, along with their brand keywords, and see where they get mentioned, and perhaps you can jump into the conversation and introduce people to your service. This is quite handy at times. Proxy rotation, in here you can just import all of your private proxies. If you have a lot of keywords and URLs, you will need to use proxies here. You can just use 10 semi-dedicated from someone like ByProxies, and that will do fine for the most part. But if you're only monitoring a handful of keywords like this, you will be fine without the proxies. So that is the general options. And all we need to do now is set up our personas and profiles within the personas. So let's add our persona. Our name will be Matthew Woodward. Our username will be Matthew Woodward. I will enter a password in that it will use during account creation, and also an email address. And it's also going to ask me for my email password, so that it can connect to my inbox and verify any email addresses. And you also have the option here to upload an image, which I'm going to do. And that's the image in. So we can click on Next. We have to enter our incoming mail settings. So I'm just going to pause the video while I do that. Okay, and then we click on Next. And then we can add additional details here into the profiles that get created. So I'm going to put my date of birth, 17th of June, 1986. So if you guys feel like sending me any birthday presents on the 17th of June, you know, don't be shy. Okay, I am male. I'm in the United Kingdom. And I'm an SEO blogger that creates free tutorials. And finish. So that is our persona set up. And within our persona, we can add profiles. So I can add my Twitter account. Use existing or register new. Remember, Buzzbundle will take care of the registration process for you, but I'm going to use my existing account and just enter my details for that into here. And click finish, and that will verify my details here and then add it to the persona. Okay, that has now added in, and you can do the same for any other profiles you've got, such as Facebook, LinkedIn, Google+, Yahoo Answers, any registrations, current forums you've got, but I don't preset these up. So I'm just going to go through and set up my other networks, and I'll be back once I've done that. So I have added my Twitter, Google+, and Yahoo Answer profiles. And now I'm just going to generate the latest buzz and then start replying to it. But before I do that, I wanted to just add a couple more relevant keywords in here. While they find the specific tools, I can also include things like backlink checker and check backlinks. So I was just going to add that in there, hit OK, and now we're going to find buzz for all types of sites, and I'm going to pause the video when it does that, and then we're going to jump in and start engaging people and driving traffic to the post. So let's start engaging with our target audience. We're going to start off in the forums and blogs area. It's picked up this post about Yahoo Site Explorer alternatives on our keyword check backlinks. And we can reply to that. Oh, interestingly, it's also got 65 comments. So we can reply to that and get involved and say, hi, I recently published a post comparing all of the best backlink checking tools. It was interesting to see how differently they all performed. You can check it out at So a quick comment, hit OK. That will now go out and submit the comment to the blog, and we can just come over here and move on. Okay, that's posted. Looking for a Raven Tools alternative. They loved Raven Tools, but now they want something else. Okay, I can help them with that. Hi. Put together Okay, another comment, hit OK, and that will go and submit it. Let's have a look at some social networks then and see what we can do here. Now, it's likely that the post Anne Smarty made on Search Engine Journal got a lot of retweets. So I know those people are already interested in the post that I'm trying to promote. So if we have a look through here, and what's pretty cool is we've got a quick filter here, so we can quickly filter out various posts. So we can see here, perhaps if we change that to there we go. So here are all the people that have tweeted the post that Anne Smarty wrote that is similar to mine. So now I can go out and say, reply to this guy and say, hi, if you enjoyed that post, you will also like this post. And we can click on OK, and that will go and tweet it out for us. And then we can go and find someone else and do something similar. Yeah, this guy will do. Kevin Pike. Hi, Kevin. If you liked that post, you will also like my comparison as well. And hit my link. And you've got a few other options down here to add your location, add an attachment, and shorten your URL if you want to. And I can hit OK. Oh, you can also schedule it out. I forgot to mention that. And I can hit OK, and that will go and tweet him as well. So this is how you can sort of build out traffic over time to your site. Imagine if you spent a couple of hours doing this each day and you had all of your different posts. You know, you can see my comment there. It's awaiting moderation. It actually tracks all of that for you and when it goes live. But if I actually jump back over to my main project, which is this one, and if you look at all of the keywords in here that I'm monitoring, so I'm monitoring things like my domain name, SEO Powersuite, because I've written an SEO Powersuite review, Content Machine, again for the same reason, I've got similar content related to that that I can help people out with, free SEO tools, backlink checker, backlink analysis, link building guide. I can help people out if they're looking for a link building guide. And lots of various terms all related to posts that I have published. And at the end of this review, I will actually be adding Buzzbundle as one word and Buzzbundle with the space. And that will go out and find Buzzbundle related posts, and I will answer with this very review that you're seeing right now. So that is the power of Buzzbundle and how you can easily, from one interface, find where your audience live online and engage with them directly. And that is the exact strategy that I have used to grow my blog, simply posting on forums and blogs, helping people out, pushing them through to my site, they're watching my tutorials, clicking on the affiliate link, subscribing to my site, following me on social networks, and it's just a constant cycle of traffic growth. So that's my traffic strategy for the blog, and you can see how Buzzbundle makes it easy to replicate all of that. While I was rendering the video, this email came through, which is a reply from Kevin Pike, which is a guy we tweeted earlier through Buzzbundle. So I thought I'd cancel a rendering and record this quickly to show you the real power of Buzzbundle. He is now someone that is engaged with my blog and will no doubt end up on my email list. So that just about wraps it up, but here are a couple of extra tips. I personally use Buzzbundle every morning for an hour to promote my blog before I do anything else. Every time I publish a new post, I spend a few hours in Buzzbundle to promote it, which is working really well for me. It really is a fantastic tool that makes it easy to connect with your target audience, and to be honest, if I had to choose between Buzzbundle or link building software, I would choose this every time. If you want to give it a go yourself, download the free trial now.